watching PTS English News. I'm Jeff. First story today, the nation's imminent power crisis further pushed back after the Heping power plant came back online over the weekend. The power plant was cut off from the grid during Typhoon Nisad at the end of last month, and its capacity of 1.3 million watts has until this Sunday been kept from helping the nation meet increasing electricity demand triggered by consecutive days of extremely hot weather. But the Ministry of Economic Affairs remains on alert, as the mercury is still expected to again rise above 37 degrees Celsius in the coming week. Thai Power has therefore been asked to be ready for surging demands.
Heping Power Plant's first and second generators are finally back online after plant facilities sustained damage during the last typhoon. Taiwan Power says with Heping operating at full capacity, the reserve capacity will go up to 1.91 million kilowatts.
现在的供电量来看，因为今天已经超过了3800万千瓦的一个供电能量。那从上一周我们的历史记录是3640几万千瓦，假设我们的系统稳定度像现在的状况能够维持一个好的一个操作状态的话，我们的余裕量事实上不太可能再发生红电的状况。
Taiwan Power issued 3 red alerts last week. Taiwan is facing a hot week ahead due to the Pacific high pressure system, with temperatures expected to hit 37 degrees in northern Taiwan from the 14th to the 16th. The Ministry of Economic Affairs has asked Thai Power to ensure a stable power supply.
那其次一呢，这个故障的原因呢已经找到，那台电会用最快的速度来协助厂家呢，把这个故障的设备呢把它修复，然后尽快的恢复并运转。
Thai Power also said it has to respect the Yunlin County government's coal usage restrictions, and it will continue to reallocate resources to maintain a stable power supply at Mai Lau Power Plant this fall and winter.
The 2017 Summer Universiade is opening in just a few days, and for the first time, all of Taiwan's television stations will help broadcast the games. But as the city and the nation prepares for the upcoming festivity and competition and much excitement, a group of retired civil servants who are unhappy with the government's ongoing pension reform say they are ready to make their voice heard at the opening ceremony. A march around the venue is now being planned, and some have bought tickets to the ceremony, saying that they will stage their protest inside the venue.
President Tsai Ing-wen's pension reforms have angered many public functionaries. National Civil Servant Association Director General Harry Lee says anti-pension reform groups will be protesting on August 19th. They will march around the site of the 2017 Summer Universiade's opening ceremony. Moreover, some have purchased tickets for the ceremony and intend to stage their protest inside the venue. Taipei City Mayor Ke Wen-je says anyone who intends to create trouble at the sporting events will be spit on. Nevertheless, opening ceremony security personnel must not be careless.
对，市警局的确是有做这样的动作，而且是不只是说单一的社团，是说我们平常我们在台北市不断在街头上运动的社团，不管是哪个单位都有去做沟通。
Meanwhile, a recent opinion poll showed 60% of respondents are paying close attention to the Summer Universiade, while 65% have faith in Ke's management of the sporting event. However, there are concerns the Summer Universiade won't get international recognition, although the mayor doesn't share such concerns.
那等到开始比赛的，等到开始国外的媒体在转播啊什么，慢慢就感，就民众才感受到说，哎、欸，这个也有上国际媒体。不过事实上，这个我倒也不担心了，因为四大运本来就是国际的运动会嘛。
The sporting events will be jointly broadcast live around the world by all of Taiwan's television stations in 4K resolution. The mayor hopes this will give Taiwan and Taipei international exposure.
Meanwhile, an opinion poll just released shows President Tsai Ing-wen suffering from the worst approval and disapproval ratings ever since she took office. As many as 50% say they are unhappy with her. The survey also asked about Taipei City Mayor Ke Wen-je, but he seems to have polled better among the general public.
The Taiwanese Public Opinion Foundation has been monitoring President Tsai Ing-wen's approval rate for a long time. The foundation released the results of its latest survey on August 14th. Compared to the earlier survey conducted in June, the approval rate for President Tsai has dipped 3.3% down to 29.8%, and the disapproval rate has risen by 0.4%, reaching just 50%.
蔡英文总统上任之后到现在为止，已经是民意支持最低的时刻，包括前瞻啊、司改啊，以及其他大大小小的问题，没有任何理由让我们很乐观的说，蔡英文总统的声望会在可预见的未来短期之内能够提升。
The survey also asked the public's opinion on whether they see themselves as Taiwanese or Chinese. 75% of the respondents believe that they are Taiwanese, 12.1% see themselves as both, and 10.6% believe they are Chinese. Though 72% believe they are Taiwanese, the foundation says that the number has slightly dipped compared to that of previous years, which hovered just below 80%. The presidential office responded to the survey saying that they have no comments. The survey also included questions on Taipei Mayor Ke Wen-je. The results show that 68.5% of the public expressed fondness of the Taipei mayor, whereas 25% expressed dislike. Ke Wen-je has not issued an official response to the results so far.
Unfair, poor, brutal, and even inhumane. These are some of the words that have been used to describe how the nation's fishing industry treats foreign fishermen working on Taiwanese boats. Now the nation's fisheries agency has decided to open this can of worms and called a meeting to review how foreign fishermen are currently treated and managed. Here's our report.
Filipino worker Rick talks about his life in Taiwan.
Because my broker is over-deducting my salary and also the food and accommodation and hardworking, I will work in a factory and also in work the ship.
During the legal battle, Rick's employer withheld his wages. To leave both his poor living and working conditions behind, Rick sought help from the Serve the People Foundation in May. New laws guaranteeing foreign fishery workers a minimum monthly wage of $450 and rest time went into effect in January. However, labor groups question whether the laws offer any protection at all.
他一没有劳检，二没有申诉管道，然后在半年后他没有提出这些补正的一个办法，所以我们要求他一体适用劳基法。
我们今天的交换意见只是一些属于技术性的，如果属于技术性的，大家可以来讨论，让他做得更好。如果政府落实的不够，我们来细心检讨。
The fisheries agency said workers' rights would not be sacrificed even if labor groups would not attend its conference on the 14th. In response, the group said all fisheries workers should receive the same protection under the Labor Standards Act, no matter where they work. They also said the government needs to do more on the labor inspection front.
Next, a man gone diving came back with a one leg missing. The gruesome incident took place over the weekend in Pingdong. The captain of the boat that the man took apparently fired up the boat's engine and propeller before the man came back on board, and the propeller caught the man's leg. He has since been rushed to the hospital, and his condition is not life-threatening, but the leg severed by the propeller has sunk into the ocean and cannot be recovered.
A 46-year-old man surnamed Cho lies on the stretcher. He had just suffered a diving accident where his right leg was severed by the propeller of a boat. His severed leg sank to the bottom of the ocean while he was taken to Anti-Tianshan Memorial Hospital for treatment. The diver had traveled to Pingdong's Liuqiu on August 12 to go diving. He went diving with an instructor and a dozen or so other students at a distance of 3 nautical miles from Black Dwarf Cave. It appears the boat captain did not notice there were still divers in the water and started the propellers to avoid hitting a reef. Diving instructors say this was not standard operating procedures because the captain should have conducted a head count. Moreover, he should have only started the engine, not the propellers. The public is reminded to only go diving with licensed instructors and to pay careful attention to surroundings when surfacing. The diving instructor present at the accident did not want to comment on the case, merely saying he has already spoken with the victim's family about follow-up issues.
Well, Taiwanese gravy is not just dear to us locals. Many foreigners also find themselves having a hard time saying no to the household delicacy. In fact, folk wisdom has it that the longer the gravy is cooked, the better it tastes and the more aromatic it smells. But be careful, because experts are now saying that cooking your gravy for more than 3 hours will likely make it carcinogenic.
Pouring meat gravy on top of the rice covered with braised pork makes for a traditional dish that is beloved by many. According to folk wisdom, the longer the gravy is boiled, the better it tastes. However, the latest research shows that the meat that has been cooked for a long time produces many carcinogens and increases the risk of cardiovascular diseases.
肉里面有蛋白质，蛋白质经过长时间加热以后，它会先分解成氨基酸。但是如果说你加热的条件比较剧烈，氨基酸有可能在进一步反应生成杂环胺。
Professor Chen's research looks into the basic method for cooking gravy. The mixture of meat, soy sauce, raw candy, and water produces carcinogenic oxidized cholesterol after prolonged boiling. 4 hours of boiling produces 35 ppb, 12 hours of boiling produces 64 ppb, and 24 hours produces 78 ppb. Food safety experts have suggested adding antioxidant ingredients such as ginger and garlic to reduce the risk of cancer.
去除氧化胆固醇的方式呢，就是加入新鲜的葱姜蒜洋葱，这也是我们老祖宗教我们的，加入这些新香料，其实除了味道好，也可以去除氧化胆固醇。
The experts said that it is okay to eat meat and drink gravy. However, gravy should not be heated for longer than 3 hours. The best way of heating leftover gravy is to put it in small containers and only heat one portion at a time when needed. The experts also advise food vendors to change their gravy at least daily in order to minimize the growth of bacteria.
Well, who knew that one of the most enjoyable things in life can be carcinogenic? But then again, a lot of the things that are fun that are out there turn out to be bad for us. So watch out, and of course, discretion is advised. And that's all for today. I'm Jeff, and I'll see you tomorrow.